While you are breastfeeding or pumping, you may experience certain breast complications. Most can be prevented or resolved with frequent and effective removal of the milk either through breastfeeding or pumping. It is important to be able to recognize these potential problems and treat them quickly to prevent further complications and a reduction in milk supply. In this video, we will discuss engorgement, plugged milk ducts, and mastitis. Engorgement is when there is swelling and increased pressure in the breasts due to an accumulation of breast milk and other fluid. The normal lactating breast is softer and feels comfortable. The engorged breast feels hard, full, and tender. Notice how it is not only milk that causes the breasts to swell. It is a combination of milk, increased circulation of blood, and other fluid. The symptoms of engorgement include hard, heavy, and tight breasts. The whole breast will feel hard, some redness and shine on the skin, tenderness or pain, and engorgement usually affects both breasts. It is common to experience some engorgement as your milk increases in volume. This typically happens between day 3 and 5 after birth. It can also occur at any time of lactation if the breast is not emptied for a long period of time. If you are breastfeeding, engorgement may occur if your baby is not latching or drinking effectively. The most important strategy for relieving engorgement is emptying your breasts at least 8 times in 24 hours. Sometimes the swelling in the breast tissue during engorgement can be so severe that it stops milk from flowing. It is important to treat this swelling as soon as it starts to occur. Apply cold to your breasts for 20 minutes after breastfeeds or pumping sessions. If needed, take an anti-inflammatory such as ibuprofen for pain control and to reduce swelling. Lie down and massage breasts towards the armpits to reduce swelling. Apply heat for a few minutes just before feeding or pumping to help the milk to flow. If your areola, the dark area around your nipple, is swollen, you can do what is called reverse pressure softening before feeding or pumping. You do this by placing either the length of your thumbs or the tips of your fingers on the areola and applying pressure for 60 seconds. This helps to soften the areola, which makes latching and pumping easier. It may be helpful to do this while lying down to help with fluid drainage. You can also refer to the International Breastfeeding Center website for more information on this technique. If after reverse pressure softening, your areola is still firm and making it difficult for your baby to latch, you can try hand expressing some milk until the areola is soft enough to be compressed. You can learn more about hand expressing in our video, How to Establish and Maintain a Breast Milk Supply, which can be found on the SickKids Breastfeeding Program website. A plugged milk duct is a blockage caused by an area in the breast that is not draining well. The symptoms of a plugged duct include a tender lump or lumpy area in the breast. This is different from engorgement in that engorgement involves the whole breast being hard, and a plugged duct causes hardness in just one area of the breast. The area may look red and feel warm. There may be decreased milk flow from the affected breast. You will usually still feel well overall. A plugged duct can be caused by a poor latch, the baby feeding less than usual due to illness, feeds or pump sessions are missed or shortened, tight restrictive clothing such as wearing an underwire bra, sleeping on your tummy or more on one side. Frequent and effective milk removal is the most important part of treatment. Apply heat. Moist heat may work best. Massage from behind the lumpy area towards the nipple. If breastfeeding, massage during the feed and try breastfeeding in positions where the baby's chin or nose are pointing towards the affected area. If pumping, massage while pumping. Try hand expressing after pumping to fully empty the breast. If needed, take an anti-inflammatory such as ibuprofen for pain control and to reduce swelling. Ensure you are wearing the right sized bra. Loosen your bra to prevent compression of the milk ducts. Drink plenty of fluids. Eat a well-balanced diet and rest when you can. An untreated plugged duct can lead to mastitis. If symptoms have not resolved with the suggested treatment, please seek medical attention. Mastitis is when there is inflammation of the breast tissue, sometimes occurring with an infection. Symptoms of mastitis include a red area on the breast. There can be red streaks. Breast pain. Flu-like symptoms such as fever, chills, fatigue, general aches and pains. It usually affects only one breast, and you may have a decreased milk supply on the affected side. Causes or risk factors of mastitis include inadequate emptying of the breasts caused by infrequent feeding or pumping, persistent engorgement or plugged duct, a poor latch, restricting feeding times, an oversupply of milk, or rapid weaning. Other causes or risk factors are bacteria, often entering through a crack on the nipple, illness in you or your baby, stress and fatigue. If symptoms are mild, you can treat conservatively at first. Frequent and effective milk removal is the most important part of treatment. If breastfeeding, try different positions, including ones where the baby's chin or nose are pointing towards the affected area. Breastfeeding should be continued during this time. If your baby refuses the breast, replace feeds with pumping until your baby returns to the breast. If you have been exclusively pumping, it is important to be pumping a minimum of 8 times a day. Your milk supply may drop significantly on the affected side, even with frequent emptying. Just keep emptying and it will likely return to normal once the mastitis clears. Place warm compresses on the affected breast for a few minutes before feeding or pumping to promote milk flow. Apply cold compresses on the breast after feeding or pumping for 20 minutes to reduce pain and swelling. Massage the blocked area during pumping or feeding. If needed, take an anti-inflammatory such as ibuprofen for pain control and to reduce swelling. Drink plenty of fluids and eat a well-balanced diet. Rest and reach out for support to decrease stress and fatigue. If you have a high fever or if symptoms worsen or do not improve after 24 hours of conservative treatment, seek medical attention immediately from your family doctor or closest emergency department, as you may need antibiotics or further investigation. There are things you can do to prevent complications. If your baby is breastfeeding, ensure a good latch for effective milk removal and feed on demand at least 8 times a day. If your baby cannot breastfeed and you are pumping, start as early as possible to prevent complications. Make sure you are using the right sized flange and pump settings. And remember to empty the breast frequently, at least 8 times a day. It is important to treat breast complications as soon as they arise. It is vital to continue breastfeeding or pumping throughout these complications. Hand hygiene is very important. Wash your hands frequently, especially if you have a crack on your nipple or breast. Clean and sterilize your pump kits according to manufacturer instructions. Change breast pads frequently when wet, at least once a day. Engorgement, plugged milk ducts, and mastitis can be a progression from inadequate milk removal. You can prevent this progression by treating these conditions as soon as you have symptoms. General treatment principles are the same for all three: frequent and effective milk removal, pain relief, breast massage, heat and cold application, seeking support from a lactation consultant. Seeking help early will help you reach your feeding goals and prevent complications. All of these breast complications are associated with milk not being effectively removed from the breast. It is strongly recommended that you see a lactation consultant as soon as difficulties arise to ensure your baby is feeding effectively or for a pumping assessment. You can also seek help from your family doctor, obstetrician, or midwife, a walk-in clinic, Telehealth Ontario's breastfeeding line, the emergency department if you have mastitis.